Time again to get digging in with Christy. This morning, we're learning how to get our gardens and yards ready for the next season.
Yeah, fall cleanup is about to get underway. The Valley Today's Christy Larson is live at the Cass County Extension Office with more on some of the things you should be doing in your garden to wrap things up for the year. Christy?
Good morning, guys. You know, a lot of people picking those tomatoes, those cucumbers, those peppers, they are good to go for their canning part of the season. But we have Todd here with us, and there's a couple of things we don't want in our garden for next year. So let's go over some of those, some ugly ones like this guy.
Yep, there. A lot of times people want to compost or work their old vegetative matter into their garden when they're done with it. One thing to keep in mind is don't work in your weeds if you've got, let's say, a corner of the garden and you've got red pigweed or Canadian thistle or something like that growing. Get those out of there. Don't like, oh, there's a lot of vegetative organic matter here. No, get those out. It's not good. For one, sometimes, for example, the pigweed many times will have seeds that are viable if you work them in, and they'll be ready to go next year. Or the thistle, biennial type weeds and other perennial type weeds, what will happen is you'll just rototill them and they'll just come back almost in several cases. Also, tomatoes, peppers, eggplants, and potatoes are all related to nightshade and they can share diseases. So when you have any one of those four, it's good to rotate, but also the vines and fruit that's left in the fall after you're done and you just don't want it or it's rotten, get that out of there. It doesn't help with for next year for keeping the disease pressure down in your garden. Some other things you want to maybe work into your garden are healthy, like for example cucumber peelings and things like that, onion tops, nothing ever diseased. For example, let's say you had a disease on whatever type of vegetable, you don't want to put that in there, send that off and get rid of that. But if it's just your carrot top clippings or something like that, that should be fine to work in. Or compost, just nothing disease, no weeds. And also sometimes people say, well, I'd like to, I got a chunk of cheese that went bad, I'm gonna stick that out there. Avoid any kind of dairy or meat, it attracts rodents. Not something you really want around your home or garden.
And two, when should people be doing this composting? When's the best time to kind of help that soil enrich and before it gets frozen over?
Yeah, if you want to, many times you can buy or make or rent or probably just buy one or make one, a composter and make your own compost. You can also buy it, but sometimes people like to work it into your soil. For example, let's say you had an area where there were garden peas and it's getting late in the year and they're just sitting there. You could actually start working those in now, or you could wait. I'd probably start working them now just to kind of clean it up a little bit and keep it, raked or black or what have you, type of a thing.
Yeah. So many things to get your garden ready for the next season so you can have a successful season. We're going to be going over a few more things throughout the morning. So stick around for another part of our series of Digging In.
Christy Larson reporting live for us. Thank you, Christy.